Welcome to Miracles Do Happen Ministries, where our pastors are Pastor Frank and Deneen Hammonds. Get ready to receive the uncompromised Word of God, and thank you for listening.
Joseph was a godly young man, but he went through many things. He went through many ups and downs in his life. And Joseph met Potiphar's wife. And Potiphar's wife did some cruel things to him that landed him in prison. And I'm here to let you know that Joseph went through a lot. Is there anybody here today that's gone through a lot? Find somebody you can look at and tell them, I've been through a lot. I may not look like it, but I've been through a lot. It may not seem like it, but I've been through the trial. And I've been through the trials and tribulations, but God is going to bring me out. Somebody shout yes. Somebody shout yes. You ought to tell somebody, I'm glad I came to church this morning. Man, this word is for me. This word is talking to me. I know y'all been through, and I know you've gone through a whole lot of stuff. But look at this man, Joseph. Take a seat for a minute. Let me talk. The Bible says that Joseph was lied on. He was thrown into prison. He was left for dead. He was sold into slavery. He was thrown into jail. He was accused of rape. Now he had, you talking about bad luck. My God, this man went through everything you could think of. And some of you, if you were to be honest with yourself, if you had been through what Job went through, you wouldn't have trusted another soul in your life. You would have hated folk. Unforgiveness would have been in your heart, and you would have never got over it. But the Bible says, go ahead and help me preach that. The Bible says that Joseph went to prison. Sister Candace, he went to prison, not because of something he did, but because of an accusation. Folk will accuse you of stuff you didn't do, and the accusation will stick like the truth. And you got to pray your way out of it. You got to believe God is going to deliver you out of it. Somebody shout glory. But Joseph went through all of this and found himself in prison. And the woman was mad at Joseph because she asked Joseph to go to bed with her. And Joseph said, no, I won't do it. And she got so angry that he refused her, that she grabbed his coat because he ran out of there making sure that nothing would happen. And in his running out of there, he left his coat there. And when Potiphar came back home, she lied to Potiphar and said, Joseph tried to rape me, and here is his coat, in proof that this is what he was trying to do. Potiphar loved Joseph like a son. He said, I can't have you messing with my woman. And so Potiphar had him put in jail. And when Joseph got in jail, can I preach y'all? And I think I feel the preacher. But the Bible says, when he got put in jail, my God, somebody promised him, Joseph. He said, Joseph, I know you're in here for the wrong reason. I know that somebody lied on you. And Joseph, I'm going to make sure that when I get out of jail, I'm going to tell somebody about you and tell them of the injustice that's done in your life. Have you ever had somebody to tell you, I'm going to help you? You tested. His faith in God was tested. How many of you know your faith is going to be tested? The devil's going to try you, but you got to hold on until help comes. Look at a neighbor and say, help. It wasn't true. It was so. He was in that jail. But let me tell you, Joseph couldn't die in prison. You know why? Because destiny was on his side. His destiny said, you can't kill me. You can't hurt me. You can't mess with me. Because destiny on my side. I believe I'll push on. Somebody shout glory. Tell a neighbor, destiny is on my side. I've been fasting. Have y'all been fasting? I've been fasting and I've been hungry all week. Oh, I wanted a whopper and almost got one. But the Lord kept me. Can you now? Hold on. Help is on the way. Say yeah. Say yeah. Woo. Hallelujah. Your destiny has already been determined. Don't worry about the jail. Don't worry about the accusation. Don't worry about the trouble. Destiny. Yes, Lord. Come on and shout, yes, Lord. Many of you, you've been through so much in your life. You're wondering, how can I take anything else? Lord, I don't think I can go through another trial. I don't think I can go through another situation like this. But hold on, y'all. I'm telling y'all that help is on the way. Tell a friend, help is on the way. Come on, tell them help is on the way. Story. Joseph looked around and had nobody to depend on but God himself. But God let him know that I've destined you for the throne. You see, when you read the rest of the story, you find out Joseph ended up being the second in command in Egypt because he held on to the word of God. Tell you, you may be here now, but God's getting ready to take you higher. You may be here now, but God's getting ready to lift you up. God's getting ready to take you to the next level. There's another dimension. There's another place that God is taking you. Somebody shout yes. Shout yes. Somebody say destination. I'm going to preach intelligently now. The word destination is a derivative of the word destiny. Whenever you see destiny, that means there's a destination. Have you ever been in a car and was going somewhere? You knew what your destination was, but you looked down the road and saw a sign, and the sign said detour. That meant you were going to go off from the road, but the detour is designed to bring you back to your destination. Y'all looking at me strange? Y'all must not drive. Oh, glory. In other words, God will allow you to go through a detour in life, and he'll take you all the way around. All the way around. And it looks like you're not going to get back on the road. But when it's all said and done, that detour will bring you back to the road. I just come to tell somebody, you're in the midst of a detour. You're going the wrong way. But you thought you were. But you found out it's a detour. Look at the neighbor and said, this is a detour. I'm coming back. I'm going to get back on pass. In the mind of God, you have your desires, but you got to look beyond what you're going through now and know that my destiny is going to bring me to where I need to be. Shout glory to God. Look at somebody say, people, can't stop your destiny. The devil can't stop your destiny. I believe I close in. Your circumstances can't stop your destiny. Demons can't stop your destiny. Setbacks can't stop your destiny. Disappointment can't stop your destiny. Your past can't stop your destiny. Only you can stop your destiny. But tell your neighbor, say neighbor, say neighbor, destiny is waiting on me. I can't die because destiny has not yet been fulfilled. I can't get sick now because destiny has not yet been fulfilled. I can't lose it now because destiny has not yet been fulfilled. I can't walk away now because destiny.
Bless you. This is Pastor Frank Hammonds of the Miracles Do Happen Ministries. I'm so glad that you're tuning us in on today. I hope you got a word from the Lord from the message that we talked about. And we're just letting you know that your destiny has already been predetermined. In other words, God has already secured things for you that you're going to make it in life. And if you remember in the message, the Lord gave us the example of the fact that when you're driving down the road, sometimes you hit a detour, and a detour is nothing more than something that leads you around and brings you back eventually to the road that you was on. And sometimes the detour is longer, but it brings you back to the road. You are already predestined to be blessed. You're already predestined to be a success. And God is saying that even if I have to take you through a detour, I'm going to bring you back to the place that you need to be. I want you to get this CD if you can. It'll be a blessing to you. Share it with a neighbor and a friend. Well, God bless you. Until then, this is Pastor Frank Hammonds of Denton, Texas, Miracles Do Happen Ministry. See you again.